Well, welcome, doctors, to another exciting episode of ACES Lit Tips. I am Alexander Eisner, a personal injury litigation attorney with Shawn Steel Law Firm. I'm realizing now that I've shot three videos. This is my third video of this new season and have yet to introduce myself. So that's great. But this is a short one that should be coming right at you right now. So, your patients trust you more than they'll ever trust me. That probably shouldn't come as a shock to too many of you. Attorneys, by and large, don't enjoy the greatest reputation in the community. And no matter, it seems, if I get clients lots and lots of money, or not that much money, in the end, they will always trust the person who put their hands on them and healed them more than they'll trust me. And that's probably a good thing. That's probably the way it should be. But that's an incredible amount of power that you ultimately end up wielding when your patients trust you like that. You also have way more exposure to them than I do. You're seeing these people sometimes two, three times a week for months on end. That's an incredible amount of power. You should utilize that power to explain to your patient, to my client, how the process works, how it works in the end, how the bills get paid, how liens work. Commonly, I will hear in deposition setting that they have no idea if their bills were on a lien, how much they are, were they ever paid, what's the amount outstanding, how many visits. These are things you could be explaining to your patient at every single visit. Hey, just wanted to give you a quick copy of the bill. It's not due today. It's on a lien, but here's how much your total is. Here's how many visits you've had. This is how it works. In the end of the case, the bill will be submitted along with the other liens for payment out of the settlement. We really are hoping that we'll get paid out of this case. And because I think a lot of times the patients don't understand how it works. And I'm duty bound, I'm ethics bound to pay the liens. Well, that's hard stop, period. I'm duty bound to pay the liens. But specifically speaking, when my clients tell me to pay a specific lien in full or some fraction, I'm required to do what they tell me. I can't go rogue and say, no, I'm not gonna pay the chiropractor 100%. The client tells me to, I have to. Now, I'm not saying you should tell every client or patient that walks in your door, hey, tell your attorney to pay me 100%. It's a bit of an aggressive stance, and to be honest with you, on some rare cases, it's not possible to pay every medical provider 100%. But the knowledge that you can influence your patients by just explaining the process, when it comes time to resolve the liens in the end, you will find that they will be much more sympathetic to the plight of the chiropractor because they will remember what you did for them throughout the entire PI case. As far as my clients are concerned, I just sit in a fancy office and push paper all day. I promise you I do more than that. But that's commonly the perception of PI clients. But the patients know what you do for a living. They know that you are using your hands to make them feel better, and that is an incredibly powerful thing. So today's lit tip is to use that power and harness it and think about ways in which you can use that to your advantage. And one way is just strictly educational. Just explain to your patients at every visit just what's going on and how it's gonna work in the end, just so that when it comes time for those liens to be resolved, they'll know exactly what's gonna happen. And they'll have some pretty strong opinions as to how they want to make sure that the chiropractor gets taken care of. That's today's lit tip. Hope you enjoyed it. If you like what you heard, you want to hear more just like it, go ahead and click that subscribe button below. If not, no worries. And I will catch you on the next one. Thank you.